All right, in this video, we will be looking at a matched paired set of data, x and y, and we will be finding the linear regression equation, r squared value, and r value using Google Sheets and doing it with two different methods and discussing the details of these two methods. All right, let's get started. Okay, so we want to find the linear regression equation and a couple other values, r squared and r, using Google Sheets, and there's two different methods we can use. The first method involves making a scatter plot first, and we'll discuss the details of when it'll be appropriate to use this method. And first, if you want, you can select the data. You want to select the data first, including the labels on top, and then we're going to insert the chart. And it should be selected at the very beginning. It should be you should select the correct graph to make by default. But if it doesn't, you can select here and choose the appropriate graph. But anyways, I didn't have to do that. And so what we want to, oh, did not mean to do that. So what we want to do is we want to make sure we go over to customize, and I believe it is legend, no, series. We want to go to series, and we want to go down to trend line. Select trend line, and it'll make a line the best fits. So this is actually the linear regression equation, visualizing it. It's the best line that goes through the data, and it matches the data the best. And what we want is we want to label. We want to actually use the show the equation of this line here. And then we also want to show the r squared value. So it's kind of squished up there, but this is showing you that this is, and I'll go ahead and write it right here. This is y equals negative 1.61 times x plus 54.4. And then it also says that the r squared value, let's move this down a little bit, the r squared value is equal to 0.91. And then we can also find the r value. The r value is equal to the square root of r squared. So let's expand this a little bit. So this is equal to the square root. There's a function square root, and we can do 0.91. And that gives us the following R value. But the thing is, we have a negative trend line. We notice that there's an inverse relationship between these two values. So what we want to do is we want to make this negative. So when you take the square root, you'll always get a positive number. You have to know the trend line to be able to do this and realize that this is a negative. And you can also tell by the slope. The slope here is negative. So you know that the R value is negative. So this is actually equal to negative 0 point, actually, I'll just do it here. We'll make this negative right here, and there we go. So that is the R value. But there is an issue with using this method to find the linear regression equation. And the issue with this, and possibly the R squared value, is that it's not as accurate. It's not as accurate as we may need. We may need multiple decimals. We may need more decimals than what they provide. So we need to use an alternative method that is considered more accurate. And we can actually find the slope, the negative 1.61, and the y-intercept, 54.4, using a more accurate method. So that is slope and y-intercept. And we can use the function equals slope. And we select the y values, and then we select the x values. And there we go. It's way more accurate. You have more decimals to play with, and we are not limited to just two decimals in this case. Now we can find the y-intercept by using the function equals intercept and selecting the y values and then selecting the x values. And there we go. We have more decimals to play with. Now we can also find the r squared value. So actually we can find the r value. And this function is this is better to use, in my opinion, because you don't have to think about negative or positive R values using this method, because it will tell you right off. So we can find R using the following method. I'll right align these for you. And we can use the function equals corel. And we'll select the Y. And then we'll select the X. And as you can see, it's negative. And so we can then find R squared. And R squared, if you think about how we found R before, we can just square R. So equals R squared. And there we go. All right, so there we go. We found the slope, y-intercept, r, and r squared using just functions. In my opinion, this would be the most dominant way of finding it, because in some ways it's faster in general. And really quickly, I'll go ahead and just put the functions I used. Okay, so anyways, as you can see, using these four functions, we are able to find a much more accurate solution. This is the preferred way of doing it if you need more decimal places. But it's a good visual to be able to see the graph and see the trend and understand the trend line. Here's two different methods, and determine which one you want to use depending on the situation.